What is up, guys? Pavadim Dream here, bringing you another Pokemon X and Y Wi-Fi battle. Today we got a battle against Surlax. He is just a random passerby who challenged me to battle, so I was like, you know what? I'll battle you. Sure. I'm using the same team as before that I used against Caddy. It's getting results. So, anyway, looking at his team, them threats, though. Okay, so looking at Hydreigon, looking at Talonflame, looking at Alakazam, looking at Greninja, oh, the threats. I honestly thought his Mega was Alakazam. And, yeah, let's get into it. So, I suspected him to lead off with his Aerodactyl, so I, you know, choose my Lapras to go first, and he does. I went straight for the Waterfall, knowing full well he would not want to come in on a Waterfall. He switches out to his Rotom, which is, you know, fair enough. I Waterfall anyway, because it was the safest play for me. I don't want a Toxic in case he taunted me. And yeah, I've got Extra Drill for Rapid Spinning if he wants to start Rocks. Anyway, knowing he would go for the Thunderbolt or the Volt Switch, I would switch out into Extra Drill. It was too risky for him to go for the Hydro Pump just for me to Water Absorb it, so that was a safe play, and then I immediately hit back with an Earthquake! Yeah! Je te love. Anyway, so he goes out into his Hydreigon. I am not going to be wanting to take a Surf or a Fire Blast or Flamethrower or whatever this thing's got. So I switch straight back out into my Lapras to take whatever he's coming in with. And he in fact Surfs, so that couldn't have gone better. He withdraws, he can't do shit to me. Unless he was packing Focus Blast and goes into his Greninja. Me knowing he'd swap, I just go for the Toxic, just to Toxic whatever the hell he'd want to bring in. And it happens to be this Greninja. So, yeah, that was good to get that thing toxicked. I mean, it wasn't my priority, but it's nice to get some residual damage. Anyway, I go for Protect. Yes, this is a Toxic stalling one, and just to scout out what he's going to do. This is a Greninja with Toxic, so, you know, whatever. It's nice to see some Greninja has too many freaking sets. It's hard to predict what it's going to do. Anyway, I predict another Toxic, so I go back out into my Excadrill. And I'm going to take that Toxic like a boss. And then I went straight for the Earthquake. They go for the Surf. Now, either they are not max special attack, or his special attack IVs are absolutely shite, because I live that with 9 HP. Allowing me to completely wreck this Greninja because it has no defense whatsoever and save my Excadrill for death fodder. Anyway, he comes out to this shiny Alakazam. Not bad. Shiny Alakazam. I can respect that. Anyway, I got into my Gourgeist because I still needed my Jason Statham to take out his Hydreigon, or at least check the Hydreigon. So I just got into my Gourgeist. I thought that was the best play for me. And holy shit, the damage. So, yeah. I frisked his Alakazam. I don't know. I'm not overly familiar with Frisk, to be honest. But I don't know if it nullifies your ability to be able to use your item. But, yeah, as you can see, that Thief does not take the Alakazam away. So, I'm not sure why he didn't Mega Evolve there. I will have to check whether or not Frisk actually nullifies the ability to be able to Mega Evolve. Anyway, I got into my Staraptor and proceed to retaliate the fuck out of this Alakazam. I probably should have U-turned, but, you know. Anyway, he goes down to his Talonflame. I cannot outspeed this thing for shit because Gale Wings. So I had really no choice but to go into my Lapras, because I don't have a Rotom to completely wall this thing. Alright, he Brave Birds me like I knew he would. And that did a clean 60-70%. and all of that recoil plus Life Orb. So, at this point, I was just like, okay, I'll Protect. get some HP back, because the more HP I have, the more damage that Talonflame is going to be doing to itself. And really, and I figured on the off chance I might survive, I'll go for Waterfall. What I should have done really is just gone straight for the Ice Shard, because if I had Ice Sharded, I'm pretty sure both the recoil and Life Orb would have, you know, all together would have taken him out. Then again, Talonflame is... who knows? Who knows now? Anyway, but in saying that, that granted me a free switch into my Ampharos, so I can Mega Evolve and go straight for the Power Gem. I knew he'd Roost, so instead of going for the Thunderbolt, which would... granted, it would do Stab, but it wouldn't be super effective. I went straight for the Power Gem, because that would be super effective. Granted, he's lost his Flying type now, so it wasn't doing times 4, but it would still be times 2, and it would still wreck Talonflame's life. So that's a major threat down. He comes back out to his Hydreigon. I knew it'd be Dragon Pulsing. So I switch out, I'm pretty sure, into my Excadrill, just to Death Fodder, and give myself a free switch in. See, this is why I'd still prefer to have my Lapras around, just so I could, you know, destroy this thing. But yeah, I didn't need my Excadrill anymore, so I just Death Fodder it off, and give myself a free switch into Vengeance, to then retaliate. And this must have been minimum damage, because this Hydreigon just survived. I might have to calculate later. And for some reason, he flamethrowers me. I don't know. But I just finish it off with retaliate, because there's no point in me switching out and just racking up more damage. So yeah, that's his Hydreigon gone. And now is the Aerodactyl. So I switch out into my Volcarona. And he Mega Evolves. He had two Megas on his team, both with Mega Stones. And he has Mega Aerodactyl. I don't particularly like Mega Aerodactyl. Its ability does not work well with the moves it has. And he Ice Fangs me. So I was thinking, oh, fantastic. If he's only got, like, moves that actually touch me. The only reason I survived this is because it wasn't Stab and it doesn't get affected by Tough Claws. I just go for the Fiery Dance. It was Stab and is only resisted by times 2 rather than times 4 Bug Buzz. And yeah, I'm carrying Life Orb, so and he's got Wing Attack. Why would you take Wing Attack over Aerial Ace? I don't know, but, you know, teach their own. I was hoping for a Flame Body Hacks, but it didn't come through for me. And then I switched back out into my Staraptor. My best move here was Retaliate. And yeah, he Ice Fangs me like I knew he would. But this is okay, because it paves the way for my Ampharos to come in and clean up. Because Mega Ampharos has way more bulk than regular Ampharos. And so I knew I'd be able to take an Earthquake, even though it's super effective. And then I will finish him off with a Stab Thunderbolt. Anyway guys, that's the battle. It was a fun battle. It was good seeing some different pokes this time around, even if it was a fairly OU team. I haven't thus far seen a Hydreigon, an Alakazam, or a Mega Aerodactyl, or even a regular Aerodactyl until I had this battle. So thanks a lot, Sirlex. If you enjoyed the battle, please like the video, and I will see you guys later.